Hey guys, and welcome back to the card review. So you know how they said that, you know, Dragunities will be getting some support a long, long, long time ago? And we're like, yeah, sure, they're totally going to give that deck some support. You know, they banned Ravine and then kind of just stepped away from it. Well, they actually got some support. So we're going to go over this card and determine whether it's the support that they freaking need. So this card is Dragunity Spear of Destiny. It's their destiny that Ravine will stay banned. I crack myself up. Anyway, it is a equip spell that reads, equipped to a Dragunity monster, it gains attack equal to its level times 100, and is also unaffected by traps. The whole gain 100 equal to its level is kind of meh. You know, especially with what you do with Dragunities, it's kind of meh, but eh. Being unaffected by traps is nice, so you can, you know, summon, like, your ducks or something and then equip it with this, and then, you know, when you try to go ahead and equip and, you know, get your effect on, they can't, like, fiendish chain you or something, or break to kill you, so, you know, that's not bad. During your main phase, you can equip one Dragon-type Dragoonity tuned monster from your deck to the equipped monster. You can only use this effect of Dragoonity Spear once per turn. So, that's kind of to help you, you know, with a Dragon's Ravine. So, of course, the thing that you're going to be equipping is, what's his name? Phalanx? I think that's his name. It's been such a long time since I've seen Dragoonities, because that deck has literally just fell off because of, the casualties. Yeah, Phalanx, because he, you know, he summons himself. So you can go ahead and, summon your ducks and then equip it with this with the spear. Go ahead and equip the phalanx, unequip the phalanx, go ahead and go into your vagina, your Vadriana, equip the phalanx, unequip the phalanx, special summon, and go into your whatever, you know, whether it be your Stardust or your Hot Red or whatever it may be, go ahead and do your play. So, the big question here is this card a fine replacement for Dragon Ravine being banned? No, it's not. Because Dragon Ravine was your everything. Not only did it send to the graveyard and help you fuel by getting you, you know, your family to the graveyard and get your turn, but it also gave you that search every single turn. You can discard a card and search. And that is something that this spear does not have. That, unlike Dragon Ravine, once per turn, you can discard a card and add one of your Dragon monsters. So, you know, you can go ahead and go Dragon Ravine one turn, go ahead and let me go ahead and discard a card, send the Phalanx, and the next turn go, alright, Dragon Ravine again, discard a card, go ahead and add a Dragonity monster from my deck to my hand. And, you know, you would even out, you would zero out, and it would just be a great play that would allow the Dragoonies to go out. That ability that every single turn, being able to just get your ducks. You can't do that with this card. Sure, it kind of, you know, makes it a little bit easier to go ahead and just be like, okay, well, I opened up with ducks and my equip, so here we go. But it doesn't, because you can have this equip, no ducks in sight. How are you gonna get that ducks? I don't know, figure it the fuck out, but you clearly don't got it. And that's just one of the things that, you know, Dragon Ravine gave you that Spear does not. Yes, you can go ahead and equip from your deck, that's great and dandy, you know. But Dragon Ravine, you could have just sent it to the graveyard and then you could have just had ducks equip it, you know? No, it doesn't make up for it, definitely not. It's not Dragon Ravine. And it really sucks, you know? You know, if they just didn't have that last part, if literally Dragon Ravine said, once per turn during your main phase, you can discard one card to activate this effect, add one level 4 or lower Dragonity monster from your deck to your hand, not descending dragon part, this card wouldn't even be banned, this card wouldn't even be looked at, it wouldn't be relevant, it would just be just for Dragonity, but because they had to go ahead and splash that whole, oh, you can send one dragon type monster from your deck to the graveyard, that's when it gets stupid, because of course, dragon rulers, and, you know, they just gotta wreck the party. They gotta, the Dragoonities were just chilling, they were having their own party, they were just, you know, just being themselves, and then all of a sudden, Dragon Rulers just kick the damn door in and just like, what's up, bitches? Oh, we're going down. Look, we're gonna reason with you, Dragoonities. We're going down. And, you know, we're both dragons here, so we're cool like that, so You know, since we're going down, do you mind if we go ahead and take something of yours? No. It's okay. It's cool. Okay, we're gonna take this dragon ravine with us. Oh, look at the ban list. Oh, we're still here. We're still at one. Hi, we're still here at one. Oh, what happened to your dragon ravine? I'm sorry. You got banned. I'm sorry. You know, it's just, why? Why? You know, dragon rulers are just something, you know? There will always be those cards. Never forget. And, you know, Dragon Ravine just happened to be a casualty that Dragunities just happened to take on the chin. Not like Konami was making any money off of them anyway, but it just kind of sucks that, you know, they gotta freaking, they gotta kill Dragunities just to even hurt Dragon Rulers. You know, by banning Dragon Ravine, are Dragon Rulers dead? No. They're still at one. And, you know, Konami could easily just go ahead and go, all right, Dragon Rulers banned, Ravine back to three. They could easily do that. Will they do it? No. You know, because I kind of feel like they like the Dragon Rulers much more than they like Dragoonies. They don't give a shit about Dragoonies. But, you know, Dragon Rulers, they can always be that, those cards. As long as the four, you know, attributes besides, you know, Dark and Light exist, you always have a Dragon Ruler for that archetype, and you can always just splash that one Dragon Ruler in and just, you know, help you do your plays. You know, you can always have your Redox with your gadgets, and your Tidal with your Murmels, and your Blaster with your Fire Kings, and then, of course, your Tempest with your Dragon... Oh. I'm gonna say, Tempest with Dragoonities, but they're dead, so... Thank God. You know, and it's just the way that they did this card, you know? They could easily just give this card an errata and just say, and take off that... Or they could just say, you can send one Dragoonity Dragon type. You know, like that. Dragoonity Dragon type monster from Dragoon... But they didn't. It didn't, and this card has to pay for it. I was just as shocked as everybody else when they banned Ravine. I did not even see that coming, but yeah. And you know what the dumb thing is that we still got three Shrine. You know, in OCG, they have one Shrine and one Ravine. And, you know, that seems to be working, I guess. I don't know. But, you know, here in TCG, we're just like, nope. Not moving anything Dragon Ruler related. You know, 7-star, that sword, yeah, you can go ahead and do that play, but you're only going to get one. What? You're saying that you want him higher than that? No, we're not moving anything Dragon Ruler related. Anything that has anything to do with Dragon Rulers, we're not moving it. And, you know, sometimes Konami can just be a hard ass like that, but yeah, I apologize. It's not Dragon Ruler, not even close. It helps a little bit, you know, you can have your three Dragon Shrine and your three Dragon Spear of Destiny and try it, but like I said, unless you need to get that dux to your hand, that's one of the key things that made Ravine so powerful, is being able to search for that dux and turning that dux into a level 8 synchro. Not this whole, I got the spear, but I don't got dux, so I guess I'm just gonna sit here for a while. You know, I didn't open up with the phalanx either. You know, it just increases your consistency of defense increase, but it... a phalanx equip, but it does not increase the consistency of getting the correct Dragunity that you need to get in your hand, and that's one thing that this fair thing cannot do compared to Dragunity. And I'm sorry. You know, I was never really a Dragunity player, so I really don't care. But you know, I feel your pain. Not really. All right. So tell me what you guys think about this whole Dragunity spear thing of Destiny in the comment section below. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this episode of card review. Surprisingly, I actually know what I'm going to talk about on Thursday, so you guys can look hyped to it. I'm going to be talking about the Burning Abyss tuner. Yes, it has been revealed, and I'm going to be not revealed, more like leaked, but yes, I'm going to be talking about it and in my opinion of it. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this episode of card review. So thanks for watching, thanks for all the support, and I will see you guys on Thursday with that. Thanks for watching.